rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Sunday, February 8th, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.76 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,234 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $227. Antiwar.com reports U.S. warplanes continue to pound Mosul, the largest city in the Islamic State territory, and the major prize Iraqi officials are constantly talking about retaking. Yet, officials are heavily debating the timetable for retaking the city and how difficult it will be. The Islamic State has shown the ability to defeat Iraqi troops in head-on battles, even when backed by U.S. warplanes, and the militants have had half a year to fortify Mosul, which they know is going to be attacked sooner or later. U.S. officials have downplayed the chances of Iraqi forces retaking the city on their own and may be planning to use the importance of retaking it as an excuse to justify the use of U.S. ground troops in direct combat. The administration has repeatedly insisted they have no plans for ground combat, but Pentagon leaders have repeatedly said they may recommend a change under certain special circumstances. Mosul seems to be a tailor-made special circumstance. For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. UPI reports, a new study from the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration indicates marijuana use does not increase traffic accident risk as much as previously thought. The study looked at 9,000 drivers over the course of 20 months. It found drivers who regularly use marijuana are 25% more likely to be involved in a traffic accident. However, when the researchers factored in age, gender, and level of alcohol consumption among marijuana users, they found those factors were more significant than the use of marijuana. Marijuana use did not noticeably impact crash risk once the other factors were added. The study reads, analysis incorporating adjustments for age, gender, ethnicity, and alcohol concentration level did not show a significant increase in levels of crash risk associated with the presence of drugs. This finding indicates that these other variables, age, gender, ethnicity, and alcohol use, were highly correlated with drug use and accounted for much of the increased risk associated with the use of the illegal drug and with THC. The study indicates that drunk driving is still a major problem, more so than using marijuana, but it also found drunk driving has decreased in recent years. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Coinbase. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. Coinbase also allows you to buy and sell Bitcoin using a bank account or use their tools to accept Bitcoin as a merchant. Opening a wallet is quick and easy, and for merchants, there are no transaction fees on the first $1 million worth of transactions. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. Reuters reports NBC News anchor Brian Williams said on Saturday he was taking himself off the evening news for several days, responding to intense criticism over his claims that he rode in a helicopter that was hit by a rocket-propelled grenade in Iraq a decade ago. Williams posted a statement on the NBC News website saying, "In the midst of a career spent covering and consuming news, it has become painfully apparent to me that I am presently too much a part of the news due to my actions." Lester Holt, who typically anchors anchors NBC Evening News on weekends will step in to handle the weekday evening news broadcast in the interim. NBC on Friday said it was launching an internal probe of Williams' false statement that he was in a helicopter in 2003 that was brought down by enemy fire during the U.S. invasion of Iraq. Williams, who over the years has repeated his tale of being aboard a military helicopter during a harrowing forced landing, admitted this week that the story was inaccurate. But his apology, in which he said he misremembered the incident, provoked widespread derision, and both military personnel and other journalists have called for his resignation. Media observers said Williams had no choice but to take a break from the anchor's chair. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
An amateur sailor has announced his plans to sail around the world to decrease awareness of important global issues. 29-year-old Michael Gilmer will cover approximately 28,000 nautical miles over 3 months, all the while drawing attention away from famine afflicting several African nations, revolution in the Middle East, flooding in Thailand, and economic instability across five continents.
The goal here is to really make people think about a young, overconfident on an expensive boat, rather than the pressing matters of substance that actually affect people's lives.
As Gilmer set off on his journey Thursday, something was happening in Washington. In local news, a cute 8-year-old is beginning to realize how much better she is than ugly girls.
Since I'm cute and they're not, that means that they're not as good as me.
In other news, a slaughterhouse worker is told to stop naming them all. And sure, an area man can watch your cat while his life is falling apart, no problem. You have just participated in a large-scale psychological research study. Please fill out the attached liability waiver and send it to theonion.com/newsbeat.
Free Talk Live, you dial in toll free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online. Just drop on by freetalklive.com. Coming up, a state representative commits civil disobedience inside a state house committee hearing chamber. We'll tell you more about what that had to do with it. It had to do with cannabis, which is pretty cool, but more details on that on the way. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We've also got more about Ed Snowden and his discussion that he had recently with a Canadian high school class about the secret spy agency in Canada and some of the naughty things they've been doing. And he, of course, has all kinds of wisdom words to impart upon you and I. We'll share those with you here according to RT.com. But first, Mark and Ian here in the studio, we go to Dave in Poughkeepsie, New York. You're on Free Talk Live. Go ahead, Dave.
Hi, guys. How you doing?
Well, good. What's on your mind tonight, Dave?
All right. Well, first of all, there's a snowstorm that's coming, so the guys are, you know, staying warm and all that stuff. I want to know, why do women lie? I am sick and tired of women who lie.
Do people lie, Dave? Because people lie, right? Not just women.
Women lie. Women are liars.
Do men lie too? Do men lie?
It's mostly women.
That's not true.
It's mostly women.
That's just not true. And you don't really believe that, do you?
I'm sick of these women who, you know, if they don't want to say they don't want to be with us, at least say so. Don't just beat around the bush. Oh, say, oh, I was at a friend's house, or I was doing this,
I think that's relevant, right? So, like, it's difficult for people to sort of confront difficult situations, right? Like, so if you...
Like Dave asking them out on a date?
Right. Well, I think it would be
difficult. Is that what we're talking about here, Dave? Women giving you excuses for why they don't want to go out on a date?
No, it's just like, you know, because I know that certain women are home, like, you know, I can hear their, you know, I go up to the house or whatever, their TVs are blaring, radios are blaring.
Now, hold on, just slow down. Whoa, slow down. Now, which lady's house are you going to and listening through the window or the door to see what's going on? What's the circumstance there? Because that sounds a little creepy, Dave.
I have many women friends, okay? Mm-hmm. I have, like, many of them. And, like, I go up to, I'm not going to mention any names, but let's say I go up to one of their houses or whatever, and I know they're home. I know they're home because their TV's home, their TV's on, their radio's blaring. As soon as they knock on the door, everything goes quiet.
Uh-huh. That's suspicious.
Maybe they had a boyfriend there that, you know, they didn't want to be disturbed at the time.
No, because I know that they're home, whatever, because, you know, their TV's blaring.
No. Did you hear what Mark said? He said maybe they had a boyfriend with them.
What?
He said maybe there was a man there. Maybe there was a boyfriend.
No. These women who I know, they don't have boyfriends.
So what are they, shut-ins?
I don't know, but like, you know, they're, uh-huh. maybe they're mostly single. But anyway,
how do you meet these girls?
Before. I've been friends with them since the 1990s.
Oh, okay, so old friends then.
Yes.
Now, do they consider themselves friends with you?
Yeah, but okay. As soon as I knock on their doors, whatever, and like because their cars are home, the TV's blaring, or radio's blaring, as soon as I knock on the door, everything.
And
goes
then
quiet.
What? When I'm do like, they lie to you? When do you? What do you call them up and they answer the phone and they make up some story or what? When does the lying happen?
I have no idea, but women are liars. It's like I know you're home. You know,
Dave.
I can see your home. You know,
Dave, slow down. You're repeating yourself. I know you have a habit of doing that. But I want to get an answer out of you here. You have to know when they're lying to you to be able to accuse them of lying, or at least suspect when they are lying to you. So at what point, because them turning off the music or the television set isn't lying. So at what point does the lie happen?
I'd say it's an attempt at some level of deception.
Because when did they lie? When do they lie to me?
Yes.
Because I asked them. I'm like, you know, well, you know, I saw you home, or I heard your radio or TV or whatever. Like, oh no, I was out and about. Yeah, sure you were. Mm. Sure you were. Right. Okay. Keep telling yourself that. You know.
Now, how often does this happen? I mean, do you ever get to go see these women, or are they constantly giving you excuses to why they can't see you?
I go out every day and like I go to try to go like, you know, call them, hang out with them, whatever and stuff, leave them messages, and then we go.
When was the last time you actually successfully hung out with one of these women?
About last week.
Last week. Okay, so maybe they are busy, or even if they're not busy, you know, maybe they just don't feel comfortable telling you the full truth. I'm not excusing telling lies. I'm not at all. But, you know, some people feel uncomfortable kind of being upfront with people, especially if they don't, you know, if they don't feel like they can handle it. And Dave, you seem to be getting bent out of shape about this. I mean, if they're not good friends, why continue to pursue them as friends?
I just want to know, like, you know, because I can see that they're home, their cars are home, whatever, yeah. And, you know, it's
yeah.
I can hear their TVs are blaring.
All right, Dave, you're repeating yourself. Thanks for the call tonight. Appreciate it. Mark, any comments for Dave off the air so he doesn't just keep repeating himself as we
well,
talk about this
issue?
He says
he wants to know, and knowing
is, I don't blame him.
Is the booby prize. It is – no, I blame him completely. You don't need to know other people's motives. You just need to parse their actions and base your life and your decisions on that.
Mm-hmm.
When you listen to what they say, that's when you get confused. People's actions speak far louder than their words. I don't want to hear what they have. Really, the talking should come before the doing. But, you know, if the doing doesn't happen, then the talking doesn't matter anymore. So it doesn't sound like, from what I'm hearing here, that these women really want to hang out with Dave very much.
No.
Maybe I'm wrong, but you know, it doesn't sound that way. So I don't know. I mean, and he seems frustrated. He's calling them women specifically, which says to me that he's probably interested in a romantic relationship.
Sure seems like that to me.
And if he's known him since the 90s, known them since the 90s, the romantic relationship would have occurred already.
Yeah.
If it was going to happen, it's not going to.
Well, anyway, you can share your thoughts. Obviously, I don't agree with Dave's premise that women are more likely to lie than men. I think that's ridiculous.
I think women would
lie.
Probably be more likely to say that men are going to lie about things like sex and food. So, you know, there you go.
Yeah, I don't think that's true either. I think plenty of women lie about sex, too. Let's go to Jeff, listening in West Chicago. Jeff, you're on Free Talk Live, and you're tuned into WRMN in Elgin.
Thank you. Now, first, I want to say maybe the ladies could call in and answer the question: would they open the door for Dave? Now I'm going to go on to my original topic,
all right,
which is your lawyer problem there, and it just seems like he's a little tyrant, overturning the will of the people, just, you know, like a guy turning pancakes over or something, you know,
yep,
on a grill, and so. I imagine you've tried to flood the place with supporters to, you know, to on your side. You've tried that.
We don't have enough. We don't have enough. We can't even get close at this point.
Can you videotape the proceedings?
The whole proceedings are videoed. There's a local
5 hours of them.
We're talking about the school board deliberative sessions in New Hampshire that some liberty activists have tried to make a pro-liberty impact at, and how difficult it is. But yeah, the local cable access channel is there, actually creating a multi-cam feed constantly. So so yes, it is being recorded.
Now, will they let you guys videotape it also?
Sure, you wouldn't really want to, because if for instance, I just brought a camera and started recording, I would only be picking up room audio, and what I mean by that is whatever the speakers are blasting out would be what my camera would record, whereas the cable TV actually has the feeds from the microphones. So theirs would sound a lot better. And they've got the multicam set up and the editing deck and all that. So really, there's no point in recording.
The cable TV here, or organization here, is pretty darn good.
Right, we can go
Ian's
down there.
On the board.
Yeah, I'm on the board of directors there. So we can go down there and easily get a copy of their recording later on.
They won't charge you for it or anything.
There's a $10 fee for a DVD or something like that, but you know, and for the time involved in doing all of that. But this, again, for the amount of time and effort that saves you, $10 is very affordable.
Sure. Now, do you guys have, I mean, it seems like there's something wrong or illegal that the, you know, lawyer is doing there.
No, it's totally legal what he's doing.
Legal.
Yeah, in New Hampshire, you can absolutely challenge the wording of, there's certain words you can't change, but certain things you can change about it. So you can't, like, completely change the entire subject of the statement,
but you can change the intention entirely.
But you can change the intention by changing some of the words in the statement, or changing the numbers from a positive to a negative, or a negative to a positive, that kind of thing. I didn't know if you were going somewhere with that, Jeff, but if you were, hang on.
Yeah,
hang on. We'll bring you back. 855-450-FREE. That's Jeff in Chicago. Your calls are welcome. You can bring up anything. More with Edward Snowden on the way. Plus, the U.S. Surgeon General has said marijuana can be helpful. Free Talk Live.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
Gold isn't for you? Ted Anderson, president of Midas Resources, one of the world's premier gold and precious metal investing firms. I get it. You wouldn't buy gold if you believed that the government is doing a great job, that the Fed will stop handing out trillions of dollars like bailout candy, that Social Security would be there for you. That's not what's happening. You might even pass on gold if the stimulus package wouldn't fuel inflation, or that the dollar wouldn't lose value, or that your retirement would be secure. If all looks rosy to you, then now is not the time to buy gold. For the realist, there have never been more sobering reasons to diversify with gold. Since 2001, the U.S. dollar index has tanked 30%, while gold has risen 300%. Right now, savvy investors are adding gold to their portfolios. You should, too. Find out what they know. Call us, and I'll send you 10 reasons why gold will do very well, free. 800-686-2237. 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used, and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate, well, I know a guy who's really great. It's the realtor Mark Warden. You want a home with 20 acres, a lakeside cabin, any takers for renters, buyers, and sellers too. Mark Warden is the guy for you. PorcupineRealEstate.com.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can dial in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Join us online at freetalklive.com. With you tonight, you've got me, Ian.
And me, Mark.
And if you've been thinking about getting some Bitcoins, but you've been wondering how exactly you should go about doing that, I would recommend ExpressCoin. It's the best choice for getting not just Bitcoins, but Litecoin as well as Dogecoin. You can go to ExpressCoin.com to get started, whether you're in the U.S. or Canada. They are a licensed money services business. You can get your favorite cryptocurrency with money order, check, or wire transfer. You can do it even from your smartphone. Just download the app over at ExpressCoin.com. And don't forget to use coupon code FTL, and you'll get up to $40 worth of your favorite cryptocurrency with no fee whatsoever. So really, it's a no-brainer, especially if you're a first-timer. If you're a newbie to Bitcoin, you can get up to $40 of Bitcoin for no fee. I mean, that's just unbeatable. ExpressCoin.com. But even if you're not a newbie, you can still use that coupon code FTL at ExpressCoin.com. As we go back to Jeff, he's in West Chicago. And Jeff, you're back on Free Talk Live. We've been talking about the meddling attorney at the local school board session here in New Hampshire, just as a general discussion about how impossible these government systems are to change, and how just to try to change one minor rule within the school board system, it just takes a nearly Herculean effort. Anyway, you were kind of getting to something, I think, Jeff, so go ahead.
Well, thank you. I just wanted to see if there was some alternative to running the guy over in the parking lot.
Yeah, violence, of course, is not going to solve the problem. And I suggest that even if he were to die of a heart attack next year, that someone else would be in his stead.
They would just replace him.
Right.
Yeah. Can you guys get a lawyer, or who hires him? Does the school board?
Hiring another attorney is not going to...
No, this is just an interested lawyer doing things on his own time, believe it or not.
He's just a local busybody. So
you need to get one. You get other lawyers that are on your side that to counteract him, I think.
But that's not going to do any good. I mean, you're right. Maybe
what he's doing is legal, from what we can tell.
Yeah, maybe what he's doing isn't legal, and somehow an attorney would be able to call him on that. But from all the research we've done, it seems entirely legal. So ultimately, hiring a lawyer would just mean we'd be pouring money down a hole. I mean, it's already a time sink.
What I'm saying is, do you have a lawyer, somebody that's in your group that is a lawyer who'd be willing to contribute his time to undo this stuff or to,
You can't undo it unless you have raw numbers of people who are willing to come out at 8:30 in the morning on a Saturday and sit in a room for 6 hours.
A bar certification isn't going to do any good here, because we run this past the lawyers last year, and best we can tell, this is legal as it could possibly be. It's immoral. It's stupid. It's a perversion of the law, but it's legal. And,
I wouldn't say it's a perversion of the law. It's just the law that people can go and change other people's warrant articles.
A lot of people consider the law to be something that is just. It's a perversion of justice. Would you call it that?
That's fine. Yeah. Well, Jeff, I appreciate the suggestion. Anything else you want to throw out there? Go ahead.
Well, thanks, Rick. Okay. So, I mean, he's just there volunteering his time, pretty much, right?
That's correct.
That lawyer. Okay. So, I mean, I was just thinking, if you guys could find, if there was a Patriot lawyer, who would do the same, because he's doing this single-handedly, maybe, that would be some kind of a place to start.
Yeah, I'm sorry if you weren't listening for the entire discussion that we had earlier. You basically have to have numbers. You have to have raw numbers. There's 100 people that come to these meetings, and the people who care about freedom, and I don't consider patriots necessarily liberty-oriented folks. I think there's some crossover, but I don't really like that term very much. I like the idea of being liberty-oriented, not a patriot. I have no love for the United States, and in fact, I would prefer to see secession happen. But essentially, if you don't have 100 people on the side of freedom that are willing to come out and attend this meeting, then there's nothing you can do. And it doesn't matter. You can hire the most expensive attorney in the state, and there's nothing that man can do. And that attorney can't do anything differently than anyone else. Anyone else can get up and make the same proposals as well. If you've got no one to vote for them, or very, very few people to vote for them, then, you know, you're done before you even got started. Thanks for the call.
So he has a backing thing of a large group of people there.
Yeah, the teachers.
There's 100 people, 10 of them are our folks, and 90 of them are theirs.
Yeah, thanks for the call, Jeff. I appreciate it. Okay. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. And this is why the Free State Project, I think, could be a real smashing success. And it already has been, by the way. I'd like to point that out. Like, Free Staters, liberty activists, the idea of the Free State Project is to move people who love liberty to New Hampshire, to encourage people to move to New Hampshire, and to get active to achieve more liberty in our lifetime. And we've already had over 1,500 people move here. There are over, I think, 1,700 that are already here now as part of the Free State Project in New Hampshire. And we've got over 16,000 who are pledged to move here.
Mm-hmm.
Even with just that first 1,700 people here, we've had an amazing level of success. That liberty activists are getting elected in different places. We've got over 15 Free State Project participants, from what I understand, allegedly in the state house.
Yeah, but 15 is nothing in a house of 400. I think what's far more important, and this never
gets a lot more than any other state house.
Well, there is no other state house anywhere that would have Free Staters in it, because there's only one Free State Project.
Well, by Free Staters, I mean principled libertarians and voluntarists.
You don't know if that's an indicator necessarily. There's certainly principled libertarians, but you don't have to be a full-on libertarian by Ian's definition to be a Free State Project
member.
That's true. What's far more important is the New Hampshire. I gotcha, buddy. It's okay, buddy. We'll let them in the big tent. The New Hampshire Liberty Alliance, which is an organization that was established by locals and Free Staters about a decade ago, is currently raiding all the laws, handing out a sheet telling the legislators how to vote on all the laws, raiding all the legislators on their votes, and they have endorsed about 25% of the legislators in the New Hampshire House. That means that functionally there exists a libertarian veto in New Hampshire.
Already with only a tenth of the movers that are actually here as part of the Free State Project. So more is coming, and it's going to be very exciting. And, you know, having just 100 or 200 people move into the Keene area alone who are willing to go to one of these meetings would be enough to tip the scales. Presuming, again, that the teachers don't get to double their numbers as well. Let's go to Chuck, listening in Des Moines. Chuck, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Mark.
Yeah, I just wanted to offer up a little something for your buddy Dave that called in a little while ago.
He's just a caller. He's not my buddy.
Yeah, it isn't maybe that they're trying to lie to the guy or not or anything like that. They're probably just tired of having the same conversation that they had with him back in the 90s every time he shows up.
Not just that, but the same conversation they had with him 2 minutes ago, because he's constantly repeating himself.
That's all I had to offer.
Thanks, Chuck. I appreciate hearing from you. He's talking about Dave in New York, who called in earlier and was bewildered as to why women that he's attempting to, he claims, be friends with, that they are dodging his advances of just trying to hang out or whatever. He wasn't really clear that he was sexually interested or romantically interested in these ladies, but it sure did seem like it.
The conversation just dripped with it.
Yeah. Yeah, it absolutely did. All right. So our toll-free number again is 855-450-FREE. If you want to learn more about the Free State Project, please go to freestateproject.org. You can get signed up there and join us. We want to reach 20,000 people who have pledged to make the move to New Hampshire and work for more liberty. And also, if you want to learn more about why New Hampshire is the best destination, go to 101reasonsfilm.com. That's 101reasonsfilm.com. You can watch a 60-minute-long documentary that is just chock full of some amazing, persuasive reasons why New Hampshire is the clear choice for people who care about freedom. More coming up here, 855-450-FREE. Somebody who cares about freedom, Edward Snowden. We will continue with some of his statements that he made to a recent classroom that he had the opportunity to interact with in Canada. Again, he's still in Russia, so he was there by internet link. More coming up, it's Free Talk Live.
Hunters, anglers, campers, and survivalists. Get back to nature. Expand your horizons with the highest quality, most versatile, unique slingshots and sling bows on the market at slingbow.com. Slingbow products are compact and models start from just $17.98. They're perfect for your bug out bag or storing in your vehicle. Give yourself and your loved ones the excitement and tradition of slingbow, a new frontier in archery and truly modern twist on this primitive survival tool. Feel the thrill only at slingbow.com.
This is Holly Thomas, Group Vice President of Cause Marketing for Macy's. Our company is working together with the March of Dimes through March for Babies to raise money and awareness about the serious problem of premature birth in the U.S. That's why Macy's is committed to raising funds through our employees, customers, family, and friends to improve the health of moms and babies everywhere. Won't you please join us in March for Babies? Start a team today at marchforbabies.org.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you are helping the state. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available now. Learn it, use it, spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
If you're looking for work, it's a process of elimination, and you're trying not to be eliminated. So here's a tip for making the cut, and this might seem subtle, but to the person interviewing you, it's not. There is a world of difference between applicants who convey, "I need a job," and those who simply ooze, "I want to work," especially in these lean times when many you're competing with will seem desperate in "I'll take anything" mode. If you convey specific interest in this job at this company, you will be conspicuous. Thus, the value of going to school on the company you're applying to before the interview. With money and attention so tight now, effective communication skills have never been more important. For more tips for job seekers and everyone else, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Welcome to the program. Dial toll free to take control of the airwaves. As we like to say here, you can bring up anything you want. 855-450-FREE with you tonight. You've got me, Ian.
And me, Mark.
Still to come, more from Edward Snowden and the discussion that he had with some Canadian high schoolers. Sounds like it's a pretty cool high school if they'll let Ed Snowden talk to them. I don't know if it was a government school or not, actually. And so there's some interesting highlights, some interesting quotes that he has to share about your freedom and government We'll get back into that here in a moment. But first, we've got Roger listening in Phoenix. Roger, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Mark.
Hi, good evening. Thanks for taking my call.
It's okay. It's what we do. Go ahead.
Before I start on my topic, that guy who called from New York, wow. that's all I have to say. But the reason why I'm calling, I know a couple whose child was recently diagnosed with autism, and actually they got their diagnosis Friday. And the bad thing about it is where I work, I saw the diagnosis before they did.
Okay.
And that's the reason why I'm calling you is that anyone who is going to follow the mind control media with the push to vaccinate children need to go to, and I'm not going to say the name, they need to go to the drugstore on every corner in America and ask for a package insert. And on that package insert, they should start at page 6 and go all the way to page 8 and read the adverse reactions that what this MMR can do to them.
There's a vaccine?
The MMR, mumps, measles.
Rubella.
Just a couple, if you'll allow me to.
Okay.
One of the adverse reactions is pancreatitis. Another one is diabetes mellitus.
For alcoholics, generally, pancreatitis is the result.
Yeah, but this is one of the adverse reactions.
Mm-hmm. And this is for kids? Is the MMR for little kids?
Yeah.
Okay.
This is one of the side effects that's listed. Another side effect is encephalitis. These are, I mean, I can't go through all of these. It's actually two pages in the.
Yeah, it sounds like bad news. Mark, is this part of the reason why you don't vaccinate Jack, your son?
Well, for me, it's statistics. I know that every medical procedure has risks. Everything has risks. Some Americans are going to die this year from trying to go to the bathroom, right? I mean, like, everything's got risks. There's always risks. When you're dealing with something like, for instance, I don't know, a good one to use is, say, polio. The chances of a kid in New Hampshire getting polio is really, really slim. The chances of them having some kind of adverse reaction to the vaccination.
The higher chance, would you say?
It seems higher to me. Certainly they're going to get the vaccination. And I've had adverse reactions to vaccinations. My son has, you know, half of my genes.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I mean, there's just these things happen. So I've just decided I'm not going to push for it. His mother's a bit more, you know, if there's a measles outbreak going on in New Hampshire, I would try to get my son the measles vaccine because I think that vaccines work. It's just that I understand that all medical procedures have risk.
Read the package insert before you consider vaccinating your child. I'm not telling people not to get vaccines. Personally, I don't believe in them. I'm not going to tell my age, but I'm a great-grandfather as of a month ago.
Okay.
I talk to my daughters, and I tell them, do not vaccinate your kids. I tell them because they're my family members.
Mm-hmm.
And I have to confess to something. I haven't talked to you guys in about 9 years.
Whoa.
I called the reason why I was caring for a sick wife, and that devoted all my time. So now that she's gone, unfortunately,
I'm sorry to hear that.
I have time to listen now, and I have time to respond. But I urge anyone, take this into consideration. You have 320 plus million people in America. How many cases of measles did they report? Over 100?
Yeah, something like that.
Do the math. Vaccines do one thing. They make money. And they get on TV. And
they're not even that expensive, though. I mean, really, vaccines, when you look at other medical procedures, vaccines aren't that expensive. Obviously, the HPV vaccine, it's new, but... you know, the old ones, they don't make that much money.
Well, vaccines for pharmaceutical companies in America made $70 billion with a B. Do the math.
Hey, Roger, thanks for the call. Welcome back. I'm sorry to hear the news about the wife, but 9 years later, you're still tuning in. I really appreciate it, and I appreciate hearing from you tonight. Now, maybe you don't agree with Roger. You're welcome to call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. I don't really have a dog in this fight. I don't have a kid, but I'm skeptical on vaccines, I have to say.
Why is it? Because for you, I'm concerned about your personality type. You tend to just not want to do things because people have told you it's a good idea.
I tend to not want to do things I'm told to do, generally.
Yeah.
I mean, if something's a good idea, I'll assess it for myself and decide whether or not I agree it's a good idea.
For me,
and I'm not so sure if putting all these, you know, weird chemicals or whatever.
They're not that – well, I mean, any medication's a weird chemical. for me, what I had is I had a situation where I felt sort of betrayed by the medical complex.
I don't trust them personally.
I'd had a bad experience with a flu vaccine, and then I talked to my doctor. I'm asking again, are you sure? Because the last time I got really sick, and I mean, you know, I came back with 103 degree temperature. That's considered life threatening. You know, like I could have brain damage from this. You know, the flu vaccine's not terribly effective generally anyway. And they're like, no, it's fine. And they wanted me to have it for work. And so I got the flu vaccine again. And sure enough, I got sick again. And so. Now, that's not the flu. That's something they call serum sickness. It's an allergy to the flu vaccine. But whatever. I don't care. If it gives me 103 degree temperature and I get brain damage from it, does it matter if it was from influenza or from serum sickness? And this is really, I feel like the medical complex, in their push for wanting to get people vaccinated, tend to not take responsibility for the problems that come with vaccines. You'll never hear them talking about it. They talk about it from a societal standpoint. I'm not here to save society. There's a six-year-old little boy that I've taken an oath to keep him as safe as I possibly can, and I'm going to do that. I don't, you know, as far as your kids going to the school and stuff, well, I'll tell you what, I don't send my son to your government school, so you don't have to worry about it. And this is, you know, this is what you hear over and over again. You're not sacrificing your child on the altar of science to society. Well, you know, I don't really care about that. That's not my job, and it's not my goal. If you've got a problem with it, 855-450-3733. I'd love to hear it.
You know, that's the problem with you libertarians. You just hate society.
That's what it's all about, right? You're not willing to sacrifice 0.1% of the population in order to keep 20% of the population from dying from smallpox or whatever the hell it is.
Why don't you just go along to get along? We've got the greater good to think about, Mark.
It's always the greater good. So it's always the greater good about something. Let's move the Jews to Madagascar. It's for the greater good.
Let's go to Liberty Phoenix. He's in the Chicago area via Skype. Hello, Liberty Phoenix.
Good evening, gentlemen. You know, it seems every single year there's some new boogeyman that everybody has to be afraid of that does anything.
You cut out for a moment there. The boogeyman does what?
That does absolutely nothing. How many people died from Ebola in America? One. A guy that came here and didn't even contract it here. How many people have died in measles in the last, 10 years? Four? Something like that? How many people have died from police in the last, month and a half? Probably over 100 already. So this is just the media trying to spin it and trying to control the narrative of what people are actually thinking about and debating. The outrage against vaccines is valid. People are free to choose what they put in their bodies. People aren't upset that the vaccines are deadly. They're upset that they're forced to take them. You know, it just really seems like...
Well, it's darn close to forcing, right? I mean, because in a lot of school districts, which parents are forced to send their kids to for the most part.
No, they're forced to pay for it, so they might as well send their kids there.
They're demanding, well, if they don't have an alternative that's approved by the state, they'll be forced to send their kids to the government school. And then they're forced to get the they're told that they won't be allowed into the school unless they get the vaccine. So it seems very coercive. Phoenix, thanks for the call tonight, man. I appreciate it. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Sounds like a wonky internet connection. I apologize if it's our side. So there's more coming up here. 855-450-FREE. You can dial in toll-free. Normally, Skype sounds pretty darn good. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. And just because Liberty Phoenix didn't sound good, that doesn't mean you won't sound just crystal clear and great. More coming up here on Free Talk Live. More about Snowden on the way.
The results are in. In a recent clinical study with Flonase and Nasacort going nose-to-nose, more people prefer Nasacort. Nasacort Allergy 24-Hour is prescription-strength medicine that's scent and alcohol-free with no harsh taste. It's non-addictive and provides 24-hour relief of your worst nasal allergy symptoms, including congestion, with no prescription needed. Nasacort stops more of what makes you miserable. Blocks more of the chemical responses that can cause nasal allergy symptoms than antihistamines. Use as directed.
Have you thought about owning gold? There are lots of reasons to own precious metals. A hedge against inflation. When the dollar tanks, metals go up. A barter currency. You can disempower the Fed by using real money. And no one knows the future. In an economic collapse, metals are likely to be a currency. Do as I've done for years. Buy your gold and silver and precious metals from Midas Resources through gold.freetalklive.com. That's gold.freetalklive.com.
This alert just came in. This special announcement is for business owners and leaders of organizations who've been waiting for the right time to build. General Steel has made it impossible to wait any longer with rock-bottom prices that could save you thousands. That's right, General Steel, America's leader in pre-engineered structures, is offering buildings at prices you will never see again. Don't miss these prices. A 50 by 100 for $35,000. You heard right. That's 5,000 square feet for $35,000. Manufacturers, if you need a larger building, try a 100 by 100 commercial building for $129,000. You can't afford to rent with these prices. Imagine a 70 by 100 foot church building for under $69,000. With the economy improving and interest rates still at historic lows, you can't afford to wait. So call 866-91-STEEL. Lock in your price now. Call 866-91-STEEL. That's 866-917-8335.
Free Talk Live.
We've had people call this show in the past and posit that the declaration of a national emergency essentially opens up all of the loopholes that they can utilize that have been built into the Constitution. Because as Lysander Spooner would put it, the Constitution has either been powerless to prevent this big tyrannical government that we have today.
Sure, a government far beyond the scope that our founders ever, ever, even in the wildest dreams imagined.
Or it has authorized the government that we have today.
I can only assume that that's true. I mean, I used to be this. I can only assume that it's the Constitution that in fact authorizes all of this crap that I thought at one point was unconstitutional. And we are, as I stated, still under a level of martial law that was declared for the Civil War. Everything they're doing is legal, as far as I can tell.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can dial toll-free here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've got Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. Enjoy the features that we share with you. Once again, that's freetalklive.com. You can go there and get interactive totally free. We're going to continue with your calls and thoughts. Plus, Edward Snowden has some more words of wisdom we'll share with you here in a little bit. Also, the U.S. Surgeon General says marijuana can be helpful. This is pretty big news considering that he works for the government. There's more on the way here at 855-450-FREE. Let's go first to Adam in Bridgewater, Massachusetts. Adam, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Mark.
Hey, what's up, guys?
Hey, Adam, go ahead.
Big fan of the show. Planning on moving to Hampshire as soon as I can.
Good plan.
I know you try to canvass everybody.
Yeah, right. It's you're better off just get that out of the way so Ian doesn't have to worry about it.
Yeah. And I know this team, but I'm a frequenter of Reddit, and specifically the Libertarian page or whatever you want to call
Reddit,
it.
Libertarian, excuse me?
Yes. And there's been a lot of posts recently about this whole vaccine situation, and I've seen the argument that a lot of people have been trying to make that not getting vaccinated violates the non-aggression principle.
Yeah, there's an argument in libertarian circles that, and I think that
I think there's some validity to it, that you are a virulent little pustule walking around out there, endangering people's lives by carrying around whatever it is you're carrying around. And if you don't do the things that you can do in order to do this, but to protect people that you're aggressing against them. I get where they're coming from. However,
seems like a stretch to me.
It's like saying if I don't wash my hands every time I go to the bathroom, I am also, what about your booster shots? Are they all up to date?
Yeah, my whole argument was that, how does forcing people to be injected with a needle through their skin any less of a violation of the non-aggression principle? It's very hard to argue with people. I'm skeptical of anything that the government tries to tell me is good for me. But I don't know. It's just something I thought. You guys seem to be specialists on the non-aggression principle. I know you bring it up a lot. I just wanted to get your guys' take on that whole argument.
Yeah, I don't think that you can, when you weigh them both sides out, you're just not going to be able to force people to do things, and it's just contrary to, you can create societies. As far as I'm concerned, if you want to create a little city or a little place in magic libertarian land, which today does not exist, where you exclude people, I think it's fine that schools choose to exclude people that don't have vaccines. I would support a school that chose people to not that would exclude people for religious, even if they wanted religious or philosophical reasons they didn't want to get a vaccine, that they could exclude them. As far as I'm concerned, you can exclude anybody for any reason from your school if that's what you want to do. You just can't make them pay for it.
And you shouldn't. They do make people pay for it.
Yes, but then they, as far as I'm concerned, you can't exclude people from it at that point.
Well, what about the whole K through 12 being compulsory in most instances? How could they exclude them, yet say you're legally required to send your children to school? Say you're not a homeschooler, like some people are, and you just flat out don't want to vaccinate your children, but you're also required to send them to school, and then they also require vaccinations to go to that school. Seems like a catch-22.
I'm talking about situations where there isn't, this is magic libertarian land where the government doesn't have all the rules that it currently has. So, A, I don't think that people should be, that there's some that the government bureaucrats know the right amount of years that your kids should go to, that a kid should go to school. I don't think they know. But B, I would say that there'd be a lot of competition in schools, and there would be schools that, no kids are even allowed in that are vaccinated, I suppose. I don't know why you would want to have that in your school, but certainly the unvaccinated kids, their parents tend to be of a few different mindsets, and those schools, the hippie schools where we don't vaccinate our kids or make them take baths or whatever it is that they do.
Hippie schools versus religious schools, they might both have the same opinion about
that.
They
might.
Hey, thanks, Adam, for the call. Steve is in St. George, Utah, listening to KZNU. Hello, Steve. Steve in St. George?
Yeah.
Hey, you're
can
here.
You hear me?
Yes, sir. Go ahead.
All right. I was just calling because of the last caller. He was saying that the non-aggression principle says that if I don't inject my kids with their toxins, then I'm aggressing against them.
He wasn't saying that. He was saying that some people are saying that.
And we should mention what the non-aggression principle is real quick. It is it's a principle that suggests that you should not initiate force or fraud against another person. And that is really contrary to how life has gone on amongst humans for a very long time.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so back to the vaccine. If the vaccine works, then how could my not getting a vaccine cause you a problem if you're not going to be affected by the vaccine?
That's
the
a good question.
No, it's not. So this one's been answered many times, and I'll attempt to answer it. Vaccines aren't 100% effective. They are a percentage effective. So if, for instance, you are naturally 25%, you have 25% resistance to whatever pathogen A is, and then you get a vaccine, which you maybe that's a 30%, gives you additional 30% effectiveness.
Really?
That'll bump you up to 55%. Now, once you start adding a whole bunch of people who are between 50 and 75%, because everybody's got different natural immunities, and the vaccines work differently for different people, you have them in a group, then you have a lot more, people that are immune to it. And so therefore the pathogen can't spread, and it can't go to a bunch more hosts, and it never gets to play hopscotch with people. So it really, I don't think that particular argument is, to me, not a good one.
But what you're saying, Mark, is that vaccines don't actually make people immune. They just make them less likely to contract?
Yes.
Boy, that's a whole different story. I thought vaccines were like some magical thing where you all of a sudden are guaranteed to not get something.
No,
I didn't realize it was only a few.
I give vaccines to my
points.
Animals, right? Yeah. Like, because I believe vaccines work. I just don't think I can make decisions for another human being.
So, but according to that, so you said it went from 20-25% or something to 55%. So that reduces the possibility that I would be carrying it and possibly spreading it to you. But it's only a marginal amount of possibility. So it's like I don't buy into that logic. I say that if they're effective, then it's going to help you, and you won't get it from me. But
it'll
I'm
help.
Not about to take their toxins.
Well, you don't have to take their toxins, and I'm not suggesting that you have to. But I mean, if you're moving a couch and you have two guys on it. It's harder for those two guys than if you're moving a couch and you have four guys on it. Mm-hmm. The vaccine are just the other two dudes. I mean, they just help. Now, the thing that we never get told, and I feel like never gets talked about in the medical community, is we really don't know what vaccines do besides that. There's going to be a list of every other medicine out there. There's a list of things that watch out for this. And if
the guy called earlier said there's a list of side effects.
Right, there's a list of side effects, and these are things that people complain about. And they, how do you test for these things? How do we find out? How about it just lowers your immunity generally? How are we going to know that it, does these things or doesn't do these things? It's impossible to prove that a medicine doesn't do something.
Steve, thanks for your call tonight, dude.
Hey, wait. Just a second.
Go ahead.
One more thing. I was going to say, for people that are questioning whether they really pick up Bill Gates talking about world depopulation and watch what he says about vaccines being helpful to eliminating people on the planet.
Yeah, well, actually, I did. I posted that this week at freetalklive.com, and
what is this now?
It was very disturbing. So it was Bill Gates.
Thanks, Steve. I appreciate it.
At the TED thing,
yeah,
and he's talking about how vaccines can help reduce population, and he kind of brushes over it very quickly. Just basically, we can help with depopulation by doing a list of things, and then vaccines, and you're like, depopulation? Vaccines? What the hell are you talking about, Bill? But he doesn't address it. He just basically sort of says...
What do you think he's talking about?
Well, later he's asked about it by, people are like, what the hell are you talking about? And his logic on it is that, currently at the time, women in countries, they're going to lose some kids. So they just keep having kids so that they can work the farmland because they're in rural areas. Rural areas, people tend to have more kids because kids are free farm labor. Right. So if you're some of your kids, you're going to lose to virulent diseases, then you might as well just have some extra kids just in case. So what it does is what his claim is that vaccines help with family planning so that you can have the family the size you want rather than just sort of throwing darts at the wall and see about how big of a family you're going to end up with. And that's his suggestion in that.
What's that have to do with depopulation?
Because that way you're not shooting over the amount of people that you would need for your farm.
I don't understand let me help you out. Depopulation. The suggestion was that vaccines would somehow depopulate the planet.
That's the idea. So that way women can choose how many kids they want to have because they don't lose some of them to virulent diseases, and that way they're not having extra kids just because they might lose some to virulent diseases.
I see.
I don't think it's the greatest logic in the world, but that's the explanation for it. And by the way, he's backed off of his claims as far as population growth at this point anyway.
All right. There's more coming up here. Plenty of time for you and your thoughts. Still to come, more from Edward Snowden and some of his opinions. It's Free Talk Live. Hour 3 is next.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Nothing compares to a good cup of coffee. But if you're getting your coffee from the store, you're likely not getting a good cup of coffee. Free Talk Live's teamed up with BuzzBox to bring you a free pound of the best coffee, shade-grown, organic, top 1% grade Arabica. But what's different is that for every 10 people that get coffee through our link, coffee.freetalklive.com, we can give another microloan through Kiva. When the loan's paid, we lend the money again. Help others, one cup at a time, coffee.freetalklive.com.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write worms in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Friday, February 6, 2015. Gold opened today at $1,241, down $23. Silver opened at $16.92, down 30 cents. And Bitcoin is trading around $221. Today's precious metal prices brought to you by Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. The Liberty Beat is sponsored by eFoods Direct, redefining the way you think about storable food. With civil unrest occurring all across the country, being food secure has never been more important. Visit eFoodsDirect.com/LibertyBeat or call 800-620-5520 to learn more about food security in a time of crisis. In the news, CDC whistleblower and scientist Dr. William Thompson has allegedly been granted immunity and could possibly testify in front of Congress for his role in fudging numbers in a study related to vaccines and autism. Last year, Thompson turned over thousands of pages of documents to Congressman William Posey's office. Posey serves on the Committee on Science, Space, and Technology. The Daily Caller reports that a spokesman for Posey confirmed his office had received documents from Thompson, which he said related to a manipulated study. The Daily Caller goes on to say the Obama administration had granted Thompson immunity. The scientist is currently still working with the CDC. The Transportation Security Administration, the Philadelphia Police Department, and the Department of Homeland Security are being sued after arresting a man on false charges and lying about the facts in court. In 2013, Roger Vanderklok was stopped and questioned by TSA workers over power bar snacks and a watch in his bag. Vanderklok says there was a misunderstanding between him and the TSA. After his bag was cleared of hazardous materials, he asked to file a complaint. Instead, he was put into a holding area, and the Philadelphia police were called. He was arrested and charged with threatening the placement of a bomb and making terroristic threats. At his trial, a TSA supervisor claimed Vanderklok was getting agitated, waving his hands in the air, and threatened to bring a bomb through security. However, surveillance video proved the supervisor was lying, and Vanderklok was acquitted. He's now suing the agencies for their participation in depriving him of his liberty. The Liberty Beat is made possible by Justice Ranveer's Bitcoinism.Liberty.me. Thoughts on Bitcoin and the future digital economy. Check out the blog at Bitcoinism.Liberty.me. Support also comes from My Magic Mud, detoxifying tooth powder, the most effective and affordable dental care around. Get a 150 application jar at MyMagicMud.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, February 6, 2015. Check out the website at TheLibertyBeat.com. A new study published in the Journal of Neuroscience has found that daily cannabis use is not connected to brain shrinkage when the effects of alcohol consumption are considered. Neuroscientists at the University of Colorado at Boulder reviewed scientific papers that concluded cannabis use caused parts of the brain to shrink and found the studies were not consistent. By matching daily cannabis users with non-users based on alcohol consumption, the researchers were able to account for the influence of alcohol on brain shrinkage. They found no measurable difference in the size of the brain between those who consumed cannabis daily and those who did not. Nearly 2 years after the Austin Police Department shot and killed Julian Reyes's dog Shinerbach, he continues the fight for justice. In April 2013, Reyes and Shinerbach were confronted by police who were responding to a call for suspicious activity at a local storage unit. Austin police said Shinerbach was growling and would not listen to commands, so the officer shot the dog for protection. Since that time, Reyes has said he has been attacked by police and arrested by police for filming. In a Facebook post, Reyes asked for help from the community, stating, quote, "My time has been spent fighting for justice and change, and I cannot continue without help." Support for Liberty Beat comes from Central Texas Gunworks, your online source for firearms, firearm accessories, and ammunition. They take major credit cards and now accept Bitcoin. Visit them online at shop.centraltexasgunworks.com. Want to reach tens of thousands of like-minded listeners every day with your message or product? The Liberty Beat is looking for sponsors for their daily news service. Support this grassroots media project while expanding your reach to a targeted market. To find out more, just go online to libertybeat.com/advertise. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, February 6, 2015. I'm Brian Hagan reporting, reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
This is the Onion Week in Review. In local news, a succession of terrible events failed to befall a 33-year-old riding a longboard to his digital media job Monday. Shocked bystanders helplessly watched as media developer Jake Reston skated safely through Manhattan traffic without flipping over on his obnoxiously oversized skateboard and smashing his stupid f***ing face into the pavement, with many saying they were horrified at the sight of the floppy-haired little shit walking into his office unscathed.
It was one of the most horrible things I've ever seen. He wasn't even hit by a car. I was just praying that someone would step in and throw him off a stupid little skateboard and punch him right in the mouth.
In other news, a study finds owning a cool leather jacket is more rewarding than raising a child. A community garden sprouts the first condom wrapper of spring, and a little turtle gorges on an entire raspberry.
Tonight in the cabin, school marm's telling about how they talk about corpulation down the school. Only a fool needs telling how to screw. Just let the pecker guide you. But come on, listen anyhow.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can bring up anything you want here on the live Sunday edition of the program. Joining you in studio tonight, you've got me, Ian.
And me, Mark.
Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. In the earlier, I guess the first hour of the show, we talked about a story from RT.com. Got about halfway through here. Edward Snowden having a discussion with some students, high school students in Canada, and covering some of the newer news about, and one of the Snowden revelations, of course, for those of you who don't know, Ed Snowden is the guy who made huge headlines, about a year and a half ago, back when he revealed all kinds of secrets about the NSA, the government spy apparatus, and how much they've been digging into your private, what you thought were your private communications over the years and recently as well. And he's continued to release new information over time, and one of the newer bits of info is that Canada also has a very active global spying program, including a program called Levitation, which allows government agents to archive internet activity, including which files are uploaded and downloaded. And in this discussion he had with the students, which we'll continue some of the excerpts from here, he had some interesting and useful quotes that he shared. But first, let's go to your calls and thoughts. Chris is in Oklahoma. And Chris, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Mark.
Hey, Ian. Hey, Mark. How are you guys doing?
Chris, good. Go ahead, sir.
Yeah. Yeah, y'all talking about vaccines?
Yeah,
we were.
And the vaccine companies have immunity from being sued. Like, they have legal.
That's correct.
Right. So,
yep.
Now, if the question is, if a company or a corporation will not take financial responsibility for a product.
Or doesn't have to, at the very least. Doesn't have to take responsibility.
Because they lobbied and petitioned Congress to get out of, you know, having the liability.
Well, every company would do this for every product that they had if they could, right? Like, nobody wants responsibility for their actions. I mean, that's just a human behavior.
Sure, but the market holds companies responsible, and companies want to appear as though they are responsible. Otherwise, they will appear irresponsible, and people may not trust them and buy their products.
Right. So this thing that this fund that they put for vaccines out there and people that claim to have been harmed by vaccines and that sort of thing, you know, they have to contribute. It's built into the price of the vaccines. They're forced to contribute, and you know, there's no liability really for them in, you know, many ways when it comes to vaccines.
But based on that, who in their right mind would take a vaccine if the company doesn't even want to take responsibility?
I agree. It seems really untrustworthy and shifty to me.
Well, people go into places all the time and sign away their rights. I mean, I remember when I used to go to the roller skating rink, you had to, you know, to get a membership at the roller skating rink, you had to say that you wouldn't sue them if you got hurt. And people sign, you know, people, you know, the product and service is what they want, so they sign away liability when you do bungee jumping and a variety of things. I think that
that's a note. I mean, you're taking a it's a known risk.
Yeah,
like if I bungee jump off the bridge, that's a risky activity.
Right, and I think that the medical community does.
But you don't get any kind of impression that you're taking a risk at all. As a matter of fact, you get the opposite impression if you listen to the experts. But what I'm saying is, who in their right mind would take a, because you're dealing with the life of your child. Measles are not even, in most cases, lethal. Don't even have any like lifelong potential damages from having just a full blown case of the measles. So why would you go get a measles vaccine when there's a risk?
Well, there's the risk of getting measles, and the risk of brain damage from measles, the risk of deafness from measles. There's risks on both sides. It's just you have to – each parent has to be able to weigh those risks for themselves as best they can. And I admit that I don't think that everybody is particularly qualified. I'm of that relatively elite camp that believes that the vast majority of the population of the planet is not qualified to have children. However, nobody's giving me any power over them having kids, so therefore nobody else should have any power over them, you know, their decisions they make either.
With all that said, though, the vaccine companies – that is a point of contention between a lot of people that say, well, I don't, you know, that's a logical decision or to base a decision on that one fact that they will not take, you know, financial responsibility for their own product. Now, wouldn't it behoove the CDC or any organization like that to bring pressure to bear on these corporations to say, hey, you know what, you ought to back away from this whole legal protection thing you got going on.
The government's colluding with them. The government's completely in collusion with them on this. So
you can't look to them for your solution.
Yeah, but that's absolutely insane. Why would you go along with a program like that? You'd have to be just retarded.
Okay, let me help you out. Oh, would you go along with it? Well, I mean, I don't know. Parents have to be able to make their decision. But why would the government go along with it is because the people that actually pay them, you know, those with the real money in this world, they want things different than what you want. That's why.
But, you know, if the whole point of this, if you trust vaccines, then you trust what you're being told about it, that you're getting accurate information. Now, if the objective of the CDC is to, you know, control disease, maybe not, you know, that's a term right there that should probably be clarified what you mean by control. But if it really is to reduce disease, and if it really is to, you know, make sure that, you know, everyone is vaccinated, why wouldn't they make that one of their objectives, is to ease everybody's mind by saying, you know what, maybe this company should be, you know, assume.
Well, I would assume.
I think it's a good point. Thank you, Chris, for the call tonight. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE.
I assume what their concern is that if they make drug companies liable for damages from their vaccines, that they'll have lots of lawsuits on their hands. Mm-hmm. They'll have class action suits. They'll have juries who are completely unqualified to make these decisions, making the decision as to whether or not somebody, whatever happened to their kid was caused by vaccines. vaccines. Because the fact is that many people will say, you know, this thing or that thing has occurred to my child. It was shortly after they got a vaccine. So therefore, you know, these problems are what they are. And, you know, sometimes they may be right. Many times they may be wrong. And that is a real problem, is that, you know, the parents are just viewing things. If your child gets a vaccine and the next day chases a ball out into the street and gets run over by a car, it wasn't the vaccine's fault, right? Yeah. Like, they're dead because a large object rolled over them.
Probably not going to be too many attorneys who are going to take that case.
Yeah, if your child comes up with some kind of behavioral or allergy thing after taking vaccines, vaccines kind of come early in life. So do you noticing their behavioral and allergy problems come early in life. Plus, some people will say that there's delayed onset results from the vaccine. You know, it's impossible.
It's hard to prove.
Yeah, it's impossible to prove all these things. But
does that mean they should be prohibited from prohibited from receiving any liability whatsoever for their products?
We have a completely broken judicial system.
Yeah.
So you're asking me if a broken judicial system should be employed to fix the problems of vaccines? I don't have a real answer for that.
I don't know, but if everybody else has to be liable for their actions, why shouldn't those companies be?
It's an excellent question.
Okay, I understand there are lots of reasons why they should be given an excuse, but shouldn't everybody else then go ahead and not be liable for their actions?
I think it's a really great opportunity to look and see how the government understands how broken its own judicial system is.
Speaking of brokenness, Edward Snowden over at RT.com had this to say in his discussion with some Canadian high school students, quote, "Democracy is about participation. We take risks. We dare. Sometimes we do right and sometimes we do wrong, even if we intended to do right." He suggested that expressing disagreement with the government is the right course of action when its behavior is perceived as morally unjustifiable. And this is where, you know, statements like that, it makes it seem like Edward Snowden, not really a libertarian guy. I don't know if he's ever actually claimed to be. I think he's claimed some affinity for the ideas, that he likes Ron Paul, but I don't know if he's actually, you know, a libertarian. I'm not sure. It'd be interesting to ask him that question.
Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, well, I mean, and it depends on everybody's definition. Lots of people claim to be libertarians that don't fit your definition of a libertarian.
Yeah, well, there's only one definition of a libertarian to me, and that's somebody who doesn't support the use of force to achieve their political or social goals.
Then why do we have terms like voluntarist or ANCAP?
Because unfortunately, a bunch of people have come in and used the term libertarian to describe themselves who do believe in the use of force, and so they've debased the term.
The application of a word is very relevant in its definition.
Yeah, you could say someone's leaning libertarian and then they could support some freedom stuff. It's Free Talk Live.
Have you thought about owning gold? There are lots of reasons to own precious metals. A hedge against inflation. When the dollar tanks, metals go up. A barter currency. You can disempower the Fed by using real money. And no one knows the future. In an economic collapse, metals are likely to be a currency. Do as I've done for years. Buy your gold and silver and precious metals from Midas Resources through gold.freetalklive.com. That's gold.freetalklive.com.
And now, for Geico's stuff found in your car, we go inside your backseat vent.
Hello, the French fry by the pink crayon. Last week I was king of the car seat, and then your kid's favorite song stopped and boom, meltdown. Remember, it took you 15 minutes to clean up. 15 minutes you could have spent switching to Geico and saving hundreds of dollars on your car insurance. Please find us. If it gets any hotter, Pinky over there is going to have a different kind of meltdown.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance. Visit geico.com today.
On the average, Americans work between 45 to 50 years, hoping to build up enough wealth to retire and live out their golden years. Unfortunately, with taxation, the rising cost of food, energy, housing, and medical, many retirees are forced to live below the poverty line. Is this a flaw for the enterprise, or is our monetary unit we call the Federal Reserve Note forcing us into perpetual debt, ensuring inflation and higher taxes? These questions and more can be answered by reading G. Edward Griffin's book, The Creature from Jekyll Island. Congressman Ron Paul states, it's what every American needs to know about central bank power. A gripping adventure into the secret world of international banking cartel. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. I will give a silver dollar from the early 1900s to anyone who purchases this book. Call 1-800-686-2237 and order a copy today. It's critical that the public be made aware of the system. Call and order your copy today at 1-800-686-2237. That's 1-800-686-2237.
I've been told no in many different ways.
I give you an order and you're going to obey it.
Well, George, you can go this way.
You can't do that and you have to leave here.
You cannot bring signs into their rally.
Walk with me.
Well, I'm comfortable here, actually.
Whoa, excuse me.
Who do you think you are?
Excuse me.
There is no video and audio allowed in this
office. No, I have work today. This is...
You ain't gonna make...
Wait a minute.
Hey! Oh my God! Unbelievable!
Why are you running from me?
Because you scared me!
Property. What am I being detained for?
You're being served.
What is this?
You're being served.
What is this?
Bureaucrats have a funny way of telling people no. That's the sound of the men
working on the chain. Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com. I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Free Talk Live, dial toll-free at 855-450-FREE. Edward Snowden said this in a recent meeting with some high school students via some sort of online connection because he's in Russia, but the high school students were in Canada. And they discussed some of the programs that the Canadian spy agency has been up to, including tracking people's downloads and uploads all across the country. Ed Snowden says, quote, "Wow, high school students, these are better questions than I get from members of parliament," as far as the discussion that was being had. We'll give you more from that incident here in a little bit. Also, you've heard about Bitcoin and blockchains, or maybe you haven't. Maybe you're kind of in the dark on Bitcoin and blockchains. Either way, you should come to the Texas Bitcoin Conference. It's the second annual. We had the honor of being the only people broadcasting from the first Texas Bitcoin Conference, and we will be back for number two. It's happening March 28th and 29th in downtown Austin, Texas at the Moody Theater. Keynote speakers will include world-famous investor, economist, and author George Gilder, as well as Sambala Nair, IBM's architect of their blockchain technology. David Johnston, Jason King, Robert Murphy, Vitalik Buterin, Charlie Schrem, and other speakers are still being lined up. Go to TexasBitcoinConference.com to get the full details on the event. We'll look forward to seeing you there March 28th and 29th, and you can get your tickets at a special discount with code FTL. That's FTL like Free Talk Live. Use that code at TexasBitcoinConference.com, and you'll get a $25 discount on the already very affordable $150 ticket price. So knock $25 off by using code FTL, and then another $25 of what remains will go to Sean's Outpost, which is a great Bitcoin-based charity that's helping the homeless in Florida. So again, go to TexasBitcoinConference.com, use code FTL when you get registered, and we'll look forward to seeing you in downtown Austin at the Moody Theater March 28th and 29th for TexasBitcoinConference.com. 855-450-FREE is the number. As he answered student questions, former NSA contractor Edward Snowden defended disclosing classified NSA documents to journalists like Glenn Greenwald.
He's not just a contractor, by the way. He did work for the NSA and worked for the CIA also.
Yeah.
He just moved up into contractor status.
Right. Noting that independent investigators have not been able to detail a single instance in which the revelations have actually harmed American security.
Well, they always are going to trot that out. Dear God, soldiers' lives, young men who have pledged to protect you and lay down their lives for you, they're going to be put in danger by this stuff. And then, like, well, then why don't you move them out of danger, for God's sake? I mean, you just move them out of there.
Snowden did acknowledge that the NSA plays a vital role for the U.S. and that surveillance is used all over the world to investigate serious crime, but insisted that its role should be proportional to its need. Both Greenwald and Snowden argued the residents of Canada, the U.K., and the U.S. are more likely to die from car accidents, disease, or slipping in the bathtub than from being a victim of a terror attack, not to mention being killed by police. That's much more likely than being a victim of a terror attack. Yet the fear of terror is exploited by those in power to get people to allow and to support repressive policies. So again, I totally agree that at least with part of, I agree with part of what they're saying here. And that is that, yeah, people are being exploited, that fear of terrorism is being used to propagate more government, more intrusion, more spying into our lives by these systems and bureaucracies. But the true libertarian position would be that the NSA needs to be abolished, that, you know, we don't need these government agencies, that they're unconstitutional entirely. So, you know, Snowden's good. He's got a lot of good things to say, but I'm pretty sure he's not a libertarian. Greenwald said...
The fact is that just because he's giving incremental advice, we give incremental advice on this show, too. We say, well, you know, let's legalize marijuana.
True. He could be pandering to his audience, I suppose.
Yeah, you don't know. I mean, all you can do, there's got to be some kind of transition from this world to the one where people have liberty. And those steps, however they go, is how they go. But I would prefer it to be more orderly and fewer people die in the process. The human beings are having revolutions and they're moving towards more liberty as time goes by. What is that progression going to look like is all we really talk about on this show. And so, therefore, I don't have a problem with transitional advice.
Snowden added the best way to propagate Western values is to improve our own societies, act ethically and fairly in order to make it desirable for others around the world. Greenwald said, he was also in this conference, Glenn Greenwald, he said, quote, sometimes authority itself is corrupt and unjust, and the only just act is to disobey it. Snowden also touched on what the rise of China may mean for internet security. He said, quote, it comes down to international norms and standards. The way we ensure our rights are protected is to ensure we have methods that are recognized around the world. China's rise is concerning, said Snowden, but since Western society still sets the technical standards for the world, they can only get away with what we allow. If Western nations are willing to stop the indiscriminate monitoring of data, are willing to cut out surveillance backdoors, and are willing to enforce liabilities on corporations who do not protect individuals, then the data will also be protected against other nations, according to Snowden. We have security for everyone, or we have security for no one. So that's the latest from Edward Snowden. James is on the line in Canada. James, what is the Canadian spy agency even called? It's not even mentioned in this news story.
I don't know what the Canadian spy agency is, but I was talking about the NSA. I want to play a little bit of devil's advocate here. And you said the chance of slipping in a bathtub and dying is more likely than being killed in a terrorist attack, correct?
Yes, sir.
All right. But you think the reason why these terrorist attacks don't happen? Now, I'm against I'm with you guys for this, but you think the reason why these terrorist attacks don't happen is because that the NSA is doing the big data collection?
No, that's ridiculous.
Well, Snowden refutes that in this talk. He says that they just get too much information and they're really
how's that going to stop a terror attack anyway? If somebody wants to go build a bomb and blow something up, the NSA is not going to find out about it.
It depends on how big of a bomb you want to build. If you want to build a nuclear weapon, you're not going to be able to do it on your own.
There have been no nuclear terrorist attacks.
I didn't say that. I'm saying is that let's say that the NSA has stopped a terrorist attack or two. The question is...
No evidence of that.
Well, okay. The problem... I'll tell you what. The United States government is the NSA. The United States government is responsible for the people being so mad that they want to do the terrorist attacks in the first place.
And the United States government is responsible for terrorism directly because they are a terrorist organization.
So the thing is that what you want to do is you want to balance out security and liberty in whatever way you do it, but you have to look at
I just want liberty, and we'll deal with
You'll
security.
You'll want security too, but you won't want it from the United States government, Ian.
That's right. Let's we can handle clear. Our own security. Thanks very much. We can have liberty and security. So it's not a balancing act. That's a government line. That's what the government guys say, because on, you know, when they balance it, that means we take away your liberty and then you don't actually get security either. It's just an illusion of it.
I think the government's terrible at balancing those things.
James?
That's very true. Very, very true. They do. I find it is a very big invasion of privacy. It benefits, but it doesn't benefit the majority, I believe.
Thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE.
There's something called the Canadian Security Intelligence Service.
And that's it? That's what it's called?
I don't know. I mean, it's one of their... at the very least, it is a security agency okay. for the Canadian government.
I'll go with that. You can dial in toll-free here, 855-450-FREE.
The Royal Mounted Spies.
There's more to come up, including the U.S. Surgeon General saying marijuana can be helpful. I imagine the people in the DEA don't much appreciate him saying that, considering he also works for the government. 855-450-FREE. You can take control of the airwaves on Free Talk Live.
You ever hear about Ghost 80% AR-15 rifle kits? At Guns80.com, they are the 80% specialists, helping to protect our privacy. Look, there are forces out there right now trying to register guns for future confiscation. UN treaties threatening our Second Amendment, our freedom. You need a Ghost AR-15. Get it at Guns80.com. Call 844-2GUNS80. That's 844-248-6780. Own an AR-15 today and keep it a secret. Go to Guns80.com. That's Guns80.com. 844-2GUNS80.
It's no secret that government and big business buy in bulk and get huge discounts not available to the little guy. Until now. Introducing a breakthrough crowd buying website where people can join together, buy in bulk, and get massive discounts on millions of popular products. It's TogetherSave.com. TogetherSave.com. You can save 20, 30, or even 50% off tablets, smartphones, cars, appliances, textbooks, sports equipment, video games, and much more. All with free delivery. Check it out. TogetherSave.com. Visit now and start group buying today at TogetherSave.com.
Do you need access to money? Do you need cash today? If you are receiving a structured settlement due to a lawsuit, or you are receiving pension payments over a long period of time, the Money Settlement Hotline can get you instant funding now. With your cash today, you can pay off credit card debt, pay medical bills, fund your education, or improve your home. You don't need to wait. It's true. If you're receiving a structured settlement or pension payment spread out over time and you want a lump sum amount immediately, then you need to call now. They will turn your long-term structured settlement or pension payments into a lump sum larger cash payout, so you'll get all of your money instantly. If you have a structured settlement or pension and you want cash today, call the Money Settlement Hotline right now. 888-785-0616. 888-785-0616. 888-785-0616. That's 888-785-0616.
Nothing compares to a good cup of coffee. But if you're getting your coffee from the store, you're likely not getting a good cup of coffee. Free Talk Live's teamed up with BuzzBox to bring you a free pound of the best coffee, shade-grown, organic, top 1% grade Arabica. But what's different is that for every 10 people that get coffee through our link, coffee.freetalklive.com, we can give another microloan through Kiva. When the loan's paid, we lend the money again. Help others, one cup at a time, coffee.freetalklive.com.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website, fpp.cc, as well as a daily five-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper, FPP News, at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Dial in toll free to bring up what you'd like at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've got all kinds of features on our website, and we give them away to you. Now, unfortunately, we cannot give you strawberries dipped in chocolate for free. But the price is actually pretty darn good for some gourmet quality chocolate dipped strawberries dipped in white milk and dark chocolatey goodness, topped with chocolate chips, decorative swizzle, or nuts. And you can get them delivered to your loved one's door for just $19, or starting at just $19.99, because they're shipping on top of that. But you start the price at $19.99 and then double the strawberries for just $10 more when you use code FTL. You want the special deals, you've got to use code FTL. That gives us credit for, you know, selling the berries. You go to berries.com. berries.com and use code FTL. Just click the microphone and then type in the code, and that'll get you to where you need to be to place your order. And you've got plenty of time at this point, but you probably want to place the order sooner rather than later for Valentine's Day, since that is less than a week from tonight. So again, go to berries.com. These are awesome berries. These are high quality berries. These are like the best of the bunch kind of berries that they dip in this awesome chocolate, and then they put in a very nice gift box for you and ship it off with very fast overnight shipping. And there's a nice little ice box thing in there that keeps it nice and cold.
Sure does.
So really, they arrive perfect, and you will not be disappointed. Your loved one won't be disappointed. And you want to go with the double order for the $10 more, because you just want to have as many of these as possible so you can share them and enjoy them for yourself. Berries.com, berries.com. Click the mic in the top right. Type in the code FTL to get the special offer. Again, Sherry's Berries, starting at $19.99, over 40% savings, and double the berries for just $10 more. Again, code FTL at berries.com for Sherry's Berries. So here's an interesting story. You don't really hear this very often, where a top-level government official comes out in favor of cannabis. Stories from marijuana.com. The nation's top doctor says marijuana has medical benefits for some patients. Well, wait a minute. Doesn't the government's own rules say Schedule 1 narcotics have no recognized medical benefit? I believe that is exactly what
is that what they say?
Yeah, that's what Schedule 1 drugs are, that they put that these drugs are so dangerous, like heroin, which also, by the way, has medical benefits.
Heroin needs to be sold as a
drugs like that are right there in Schedule 1, which means
huffing gasoline, but I guess gasoline, I don't know if as a drug it doesn't have any benefits, but it certainly runs a car.
I don't know if gasoline is considered a drug.
Well, if huffing it, I don't know. I mean, it should be considered a drug at that point. It's a foreign...
You're inhaling fumes. I mean, I don't know if that's necessary. I don't know. How do you define a drug? I guess a drug would be something that alters one's chemical makeup or whatever.
I think it should be refined in some way. I wouldn't even define marijuana or mushrooms as drugs.
I don't know if huffing gasoline is altering your chemical makeup as much as it is just destroying your brain or something like that, just eliminating brain cells. I don't know if that's considered the same thing. Your thoughts are welcome. 855-450-FREE. In a Wednesday appearance on CBS This Morning, Dr. Vivek Murthy, Surgeon General of the United States, said, quote, "We have some preliminary data showing that for certain medical conditions and symptoms, that marijuana can be helpful." He says, "I think we have to use that data to drive policymaking." Calling the debate about marijuana an interesting story that's unfolding in our country right now, Murthy said, quote, "We have to see what science tells us about the efficacy of marijuana, and I think we're going to get a lot more data on that as more states change their laws." And by the way, we've had a lot of data on that. There has been a lot of data on marijuana and how good it can be for people with certain medical conditions for a long time.
Whether or not this guy has seen it all is another question, but there are reams and reams of data already on this topic, although I do agree that as it becomes more legal to run studies on marijuana and other drugs, we will certainly learn more of value. For now, however, the Surgeon General's comments that cannabis does indeed have benefits for some patients is likely to add fuel to the debate about the drug's status under federal law as a Schedule I controlled substance. That category is reserved, as we discussed, for drugs that have no accepted medical value. Murthy isn't the first Surgeon General to wade into the debate about marijuana and drug policy. In 1993, Jocelyn Elders, the Surgeon General under the Clinton administration, said the U.S. should seriously consider legalizing drugs. She said at the time, quote, "I do feel we'd markedly reduce our crime rate if drugs were legalized." And at the same time, since leaving office, Elders has actively campaigned for states to pass medical marijuana laws. Good for her for keeping that going. Another doctor that President Obama considered nominating to be Surgeon General, CNN's Sanjay Gupta, has strongly endorsed medical marijuana. And by the way, that was a total turnaround for him. We talked about Gupta's story, whereas he used to be this talking head on CNN who was very much a drug warrior. Somehow, I don't remember the exact details, but somehow he was had his eyes opened about this and actually did the research and came out with a full-length documentary about how helpful weed can be for people.
Yep, he really turned himself around on it. For me, it didn't really matter. Okay, so early on, I changed my mind. I was like, medical marijuana, come on. Look, I think people should be able to smoke pot, but medical, come on. I mean, it just...
Just be honest, you want to get high, right?
Right, that's how I felt.
Uh-huh.
But then I decided, you know, what business of it is mine? If somebody... I wouldn't tell somebody they can't take, you know, whatever, bear toenails to make themselves feel better. There's every kind of nutraceutical out there to fix whatever, and most of them are BS. Some of them work. I've seen it happen. But that's their business, and they should be able to decide. It's not my business. If you're going to include somebody, you should include their doctor and exclude yourself.
Let's go to James. He's in Arizona via Skype. James, you're on Free Talk Live. Hello.
Good evening, gentlemen.
Go ahead. Good evening.
I kid.
That was pretty funny.
It's good. Yeah, he gets some zingers good. In.
You're on the air. Go ahead.
Yeah, Ian Bernard. I'm trying to reconcile your praise for the American defector.
Edward Snowden. The hero who outed the NSA for doing all kinds of horrible, invasive things to our privacy.
I know the New Hampshire's never going to be invaded by marauding murderers like ISIS because of NSA and the American military, which I'm glad I spend my tax money on. But I digress.
Yeah, I'm not worried about ISIS. Not at all. This actually came up at a recent hearing at the State House.
They're not. You shouldn't have to worry because you don't.
No, because we're surrounded by people who own guns here. It's fine.
You're surrounded by Portsmouth Naval Hospital and many other military bases.
The hospital is going to somehow protect people from ISIS?
There's no marauding terrorists anywhere American troops are, including especially America.
But what are you talking about? American troops are in the Middle East, and there's plenty of terrorism going on over there.
American troops are nowhere where ISIS is. Name one place where ISIS is that there are American troops. But I want to ask you about Edward Snowden.
Go right ahead.
Who's harboring the American defector and traitor?
Harboring? Okay, the Russian government is giving him a place to stay on like an annual basis. You know, they just sort of
renew it. I don't think they're paying
it.
His rent.
No, I don't.
Same guy who's a gangster government owns Russia today.
Okay. That's accurate.
These are so-called libertarians I'm submitting to the audience, your national, international audience, that you guys...
Don't we talk about when the United States government gets it right versus other governments?
I never hear you praise the United States government.
Just yeah, I got like nothing good to say about them.
Well, I've got plenty of good things to say about it. When I look at lists, the United States of freest places on the earth, the United States tends to be near the top. I'd say that it's probably arguably in the top 10 freest places on the planet.
Thanks, James, for the
Beats
call tonight.
Russia.
Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. What's he suggesting?
I think Snowden would like to come back if he could.
You know, well, you're right, but he doesn't want to be thrown into a military tribunal, stripped of all of his rights, and then thrown into a military, or, you know, not necessarily a military jail cell, but thrown into a jail cell without, you know, proper due process as some sort of a terrorist or whatever. But was James sort of suggesting there that Russia, because they do some bad stuff, isn't doing the right thing with Edward Snowden? I mean, because, you know, just because they get it wrong a bunch doesn't mean they can't get it right as well. And sure, the United States still kind of has free speech some ways. There's some things that are okay. It's Free Talk Live. There's more coming up. Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
Khalid lives in Gaza. He makes his living as a taxi driver. The engine in his old beater blew up. Now, he makes good money driving people in his cab, but he couldn't afford the $1,300 for a new engine. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan for the engine, and he's back on the road. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel anytime. coffee.freetalklive.com.
The human body is extraordinary. Despite all the stresses we inflict upon it, it still works hard to stay in balance. Thousands upon thousands of people rely upon Heart and Body Extract to help their body stay balanced. This excellent 100% natural herbal formula helps maintain healthy blood pressure levels, cleans arteries, promotes good circulation, balances cholesterol, and more. HB Extract, paired with healthy lifestyle choices like good nutrition and exercise, can give you a life free of pain, sickness, and fear. Recapture your youthful vitality and experience your body healing itself with the aid of HB Extract. It's extremely effective and it starts working in just days. Visit HBExtract.com to learn more and to read scores of testimonials from satisfied customers. And we've never increased our price in over 10 years. That makes Heart and Body Extract as great a value now as it was the first day we sold it. A healthy heart is a happy heart. Call 866-295-5305 or go to HBExtract.com.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on joined the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
Did you know that Free Aid is a mutual aid, educational, and networking organization? At Free Aid, we support volunteers who provide first aid. We do outreach to the public about health and safety, and we bring together medically skilled freedom lovers. Free Aid is made possible by your generous support. Donors can receive great gifts like first aid kits, t-shirts, silver dime cards, and hoodies. The Free Aid Silver Dime Card Project is sponsored in part by Roberts & Roberts Brokerage, Freedom's Phoenix, and Don't Tread on Meme. Visit fr33aid.com.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. You may dial in toll-free to bring up whatever you'd like at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Join us online. Just go to freetalklive.com and enjoy the features that we share with you there. Once again, that's freetalklive.com. And with you tonight, you've got me, Ian.
And me, Mark.
And also our Skype username, lrn.fm. Oh, hey, by the way, we've actually had some folks taking advantage of the special offer for the free basic ticket to the Liberty Forum. They've never offered this before, Mark, to get free admission to the Liberty Forum, the premier convention, the Liberty Convention that happens here in New Hampshire. I would say it's premier for around the world. This is an awesome event that attracts hundreds of attendees every single year. We've had amazing guest speakers in the past, including Ron Paul, John Stossel, so many different big names. This year, Ben Swan will be one of the keynote speakers, Jeffrey Tucker as well. And you can go to nhlibertyforum.com, plus Patrick Byrne from Overstock.com, yet another one of the keynote speakers. And then there's probably a few dozen others who are speaking there on panel discussions and regular just solo speeches. You go to nhlibertyforum.com to learn more about the event. And don't get your ticket yet for the Liberty Forum. That's a weird thing to say, because here's how you get it for free. What you do is you go and register for your room with the Radisson in Manchester. Use code LF2015. Register for March 5th, 6th, and 7th, those nights. So it's Thursday through Sunday. So Thursday is the 5th. So Thursday, Friday, Saturday night, March 5th through the 8th, you register for 3 nights, forward me, Ian at freetalklive.com, forward me your registration information, and I'll forward that to the organizer of Liberty Forum. She'll put your name on the list of people who get gratis basic admission
Sweet.
To the event. Easy to do. Don't forget
You need a hotel room anyway.
It's a no-brainer. And you're going to want to stay the entire time. So again, you have to get all 3 nights to get this deal. Use code LF2015 when you reserve the hotel room. That way they know for sure that you've reserved it for the Liberty Forum. This offer expires on the 12th. So again, once you register, send the registration information to me at ian@freetalklive.com. You have 4 more days to accomplish this if you want to get in on this offer. So thank you. And we'll look forward to seeing you there, because Free Talk Live will be broadcasting live. Robert is in Conway, Arizona. Robert, you're on Free Talk Live. Actually, you're in Arkansas, aren't you?
Yes, sir.
Okay, they got that wrong. Go ahead, Robert, and you're listening to KSMD.
Yes, I do a weekly radio show on a cannabis plant, so I thought maybe I could help you guys out.
Okay, sure.
Go right ahead.
The government's got a big issue right now because the plant, the cannabis plant, still a Schedule One. However, the only chemical that makes it illegal is the Delta-9 THC. Well, the synthetic Delta-9 is called Marinol, mm-hmm. and you can buy it in any drugstore in the U.S. with a prescription, and it's a Class 3 drug.
Yeah, that's interesting.
Yeah.
That's because it's made by the drug companies, and they get a little bit of favoritism, right?
Oh, exactly. Yeah. And the price comparison, if you have a prescription from your doctor, that pill is 2,110% more expensive than the best grade cannabis in California.
It's ridiculous.
And it's also, the THC, whatever the drug you...
Yeah. Marinol.
Not Marinol, but the drug that it refers
Delta-9
to.
Delta-9.
Yeah, it doesn't have all of the things
exactly.
that make people feel better about marijuana. I mean, there's different.
It doesn't have the CBDs and the other.
It's lacking. It's lacking the other 368 chemicals in that plant.
Not only that, but the delivery is less than desirable of the actual drug, because when somebody is having whatever issue of health that the marijuana should help them with, whenever they're having an onset of that issue, the smoked cannabis or vaporized cannabis will take effect nearly instantly, or at the very least within seconds.
Exactly. It's a matter of minutes, and you know, and you can self-regulate your dosage, where the pharmaceutical, whatever dosage you get is what you get in your body.
Well, and, obviously you can cut a pharmaceutical, but still it takes time for it to be absorbed by the digestive process and into the bloodstream and all of that. Good points tonight, Robert, and thank you for sharing. I do appreciate it. Let's go to Tom. He's in Des Moines. Tom, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Mark.
I appreciate it.
Sure,
what
Tom.
I wanted to comment on was your about the immunizations. My daughter-in-law carries the gene for autism. It's very prevalent in her family, both of her brothers and one uncle. When when they had, when my son and my daughter-in-law had their two sons, my son read some information somewhere where this measles, mumps, and rubella vaccination can cause autism. It can trip that gene. So they did not immunize those two boys until they were 5 years old.
Mm-hmm.
And they're fine. Another thing about this flu vaccination, the reason that they have indemnity against prosecution is because if they don't, no drug company will make it. That flu vaccination is different every year. There's no studies done, really, that could determine whether it's going to be good for you or not. So my family, we refuse to take a flu vaccination. But that's the reason why people can't prosecute the drug companies. If the government didn't give them immunization, nobody would make it.
Yeah, I would think that might be the case. It just makes them too liable for whatever reason, and that's why they chose to do it. It's an argument from utility, not an argument from morality. And if people are so suspect of a product that it drives it off the market, then I don't know what to say about that.
Well, every epidemic ever started always comes from an inoculation. If it's malaria, it comes from a mosquito, but you're still inoculated. After the First World War, they had some vaccination that they were giving returning soldiers from Europe, and they had a horrendous death toll from that. But here again, it comes from an inoculation. You're better off to stay away from the needles if you can.
Thanks, Tom.
There's no pharmaceutical drug on the market that does not have serious negative side effects.
I'm with you. Thanks for the advice. Appreciate the thoughts. Thanks for the call. Toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. Now, Mark, I know you wanted me to talk about Kyle Tasker tonight.
Yes.
This is a gentleman who is a young guy, actually. I don't know how old he is, but I'm guessing mid-20s.
He's a state rep.
State representative, one of 400 here in New Hampshire. And he has made a headline, at the very least at this point, my headline. I wrote the story over at freekeen.com. Headline is State Rep commits cannabis civil disobedience in front of committee. He was testifying in front of the Criminal Justice Committee at the State House Legislative Office Building. And the testimony was about whether or not the committee should form another committee in order to, or not the committee forming the committee, that the State House, the full House, should pass a bill that would form a committee that would study the idea of legalization. So this is
sounds like them, yeah.
Yeah, this is a ways away from anything meaningful actually happening. But in
lots of meaningful things have happened, like Alaska, Oregon, Colorado, Washington. It seems like there's another state too that has legalized marijuana for recreational purposes. If your state doesn't do it, like New Hampshire hasn't, then you're gonna be left in the dirt.
It's certainly true, Mark, that now that other states have gone first, it's going to be easier to have this discussion. Because I've been to a lot of these cannabis hearings at the State House, and in the past, the committee members, many of them were quite frightened of the idea of legalization.
Sure.
One of the big objections is, well, you know, even if we do legalize it, what if the federal government comes in here and forces their way on us and that kind of thing?
They could very well do that. They haven't done it so far in these
Colorado,
other states.
In Colorado, Washington, which will be a big point that can be made.
But I love how the fact that these politicians dither and wring their hands over this stuff. And then when 100 activists go on the State House lawn and smoke pot, right there as a form of civil disobedience on 420, they don't do anything. They actually keep the cops away.
Well, I don't know if the politicians are ordering the police to stay away. That's the police deciding.
Somebody is.
Right. It's the police deciding to use discretion in that particular case. But so Tasker was testifying in front of this committee, and there's video of this, and I think it might be worth playing on the air because the audio is pretty good. I did boost the audio up, and what happens is it's like a six-minute video. Tasker is actually using props to make a point about legalizing and the different kind of delivery methods that marijuana will be available in if there's a legal market to help educate the committee, many of whom have already heard all of this before. And he actually pulls out cookies a vaporizer, and a tincture bottle. And one of those items may very well have been real. And he essentially committed civil disobedience because there's no way to prove what was in that tincture bottle. And mm-hmm. he didn't really admit it on the stand. There was a state cop sitting right behind him the entire time who didn't move a finger to arrest him. We'll tell you more about it tomorrow night. You can join us online in the meantime at freetalklive.com. Are you looking for an excuse to come check out New Hampshire this fall? You're invited to Keenvention. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year's keynote speeches and panels will be announced via the Keenvention blog and Facebook, so stay tuned there for the latest. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 30th through November 1st. Tickets are available now at a special super early bird price of just $40 via credit card or Bitcoin. That $40 price only lasts through early March, so don't delay. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more and look for our page and event on Facebook. That's